To get technical and discuss some tools used by the pros to forecast market movements. Lewis Mendelson is chief technical analyst at ProfitTaker.com. He's also written a book on using intermarket analysis to beat the markets. Well, he is joining us now from Tampa, Florida to explain more. Welcome to Bloomberg.
Thank you.
What are the technicals telling you about the current market environment?
Well, it looks like we may be making a bottom here, possibly in the next couple of days.
You're talking about the NASDAQ.
On the NASDAQ, the Dow Jones Industrial Average on our forecasts indicated a possible turn on Friday, after the close on Friday.
So we may have already seen a bottom in the Dow.
Yes, and also in the S&P. We actually forecast three major indicators, and on the Dow and the S&P, one of those indicators turned on Friday. And on the NASDAQ and the NASDAQ 100, that same indicator turned last night. So we have the other two indicators that we really want to see confirm the first indicator before we could really feel confident.
What needs to happen today at the NASDAQ for you, for your system to tell you that we have put in a bottom?
Well, interestingly, it doesn't even have to mean that the market has to go up a lot. For instance, on the Dow, even though yesterday's close was pretty much flat, the second indicator that we look at, which is a forecasted five-day moving average for 2 days into the future, that indicator went from negative to positive yesterday.
Excuse me, Mr. Russell. I was just going to say, you talked about the five-day, or the two-day moving average. You also have this rating system. And explain to us exactly what this rating system is and how you weigh it against the moving average.
Well, what we do is we have three. We have a neural index which tells whether a market is going to make a bottom or a top. And that goes from a zero to a one. And on the Dow and the S&P, that moved from zero to one on Friday. And on yesterday on the NASDAQ, it went from zero to one. The two moving average forecasts are used in a crossover approach where we use a predicted moving average and we compare it to an actual. And when the predicted turns and crosses the actual, that will indicate that the market is going to be moving in the opposite direction. So we may be seeing a base forming in the next day or two on the NASDAQ, and possibly if all four of those markets all show the same type of indication, that would give me a lot of confidence that we may be making a bottom here.
How do you differentiate between the predicted information and the lagging information?
Well, what we use is we use intermarket data. We're not looking simply at each market individually by itself the way most technicians look. We are looking at 10 markets simultaneously and using that information through the use of a mathematical tool called neural networks, which basically does pattern recognition on data. And by doing that, we're able to make forecasts of those target markets. And so we eliminate the lag by doing that, by being able to predict ahead up to 4 days into the future.
Okay, Lewis Mendelson, thank you so much for joining us. Coming
to
us from Tampa, Florida, of course, he is the technical analyst at ProfitTaker.com.